Hello everyone. In the previous session, we studied about laws of refraction. Now, in this session, we study the dependence of wavelength on refractive index of medium. Suppose here, a ray of light travels from rarer medium to the denser medium. I is the angle of incidence. Then we get here angle of refraction, R. Here, if we observe the figure, when ray travels from rarer with refractive index mu 1 to the denser medium with refractive index mu 2, then the refracted ray bends towards the normal. So here, the angle of refraction is less than angle of incidence. Okay, here is the Snell's law of refraction. You also studied about this. Refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is the ratio of absolute refractive index of second medium to the absolute refractive index of first medium, that is sin I upon sin R. Also, it is equal to velocity in first medium divided by velocity in second medium. If we formulate these to V1 and V2, then we get relation this mu 2 refractive index of second medium with respect to first medium is equal to frequency into wavelength in the first medium divided by frequency into wavelength of light in second medium. Here, when ray of light travels from one medium to the another medium, its frequency remains constant, but its velocity wavelength changes. So, we get here formula lambda 1 upon lambda 2. So, lambda is nothing but the wavelength of light. So we got here the relation of refractive index and wavelength of light. Okay. Also, one thing is here, as angle of incidence is greater and angle of refraction is smaller here, then this ratio sin I upon sin R becomes greater than 1. So V1 upon V2 also becomes greater than 1. So we can say here using this formula V1 is greater than V2. What it indicates? That velocity of light in first medium, that is rarer medium, is greater than the velocity of light in denser medium. This is the experimental result and also the theoretical result by the Huygens wave theory of light. Okay, thank you.